You ready?
Yes. This is a series where I, Pekka, test the high-strength stainless steel hollow sections with Jamie Hyneman. If you are interested, you can continue watching.
You know, Pekka, when the Titanic sank, there was a lot more going on than just a ship hitting an iceberg. It had to do with the cold and other factors, and that's what we're going to test today.
Excellent.
And this cold test won't be done in the lab, but in the land of the cool. Although Jamie had some doubts about it.
Remind me again while we're out here.
Because this is the beauty of the Finnish nature.
Oh, right. So we've got these two tubes, and they're both filled with water. And we're going to put them in the tank filled with liquid nitrogen, and it's very, very cold. So the water inside these things is going to freeze. When water freezes, as you know, it expands, but it's got nowhere to go. And they're not going to like it. One of them might actually break.
Yes. So, just as Amy said, we are comparing the carbon steel S355 against Stala 350, which is a direct substitute to it. Except that it is better in every single way. Well, I'm glad you asked. It brings out the best qualities of the austenitic stainless steel, the high-level corrosion resistance and toughness, excellent formability and weldability, and its light weight and lower life cycle cost.
Are you ready?
And a sustainable, safe, and cost-effective. Now I'm ready.
Hold on, Tommy. That box isn't going to hold it. It looks nice, but temperature's too much. Use that. You can put that in there. Those tubes are complaining.
Yes.
They don't like that.
They don't have a good time right now. Boom goes the dynamite.
That had to be it.
Yes.
Yeah, there's the crack. You see where the ice is.
Yes.
Can you hold that? I'll pull out the Stala 350. Nope, no water on it. Seems like it was hardly affected at all. So the thing about the Stala 350 is that it remains plastic at those temperatures. So it can adapt to whatever kind of stresses that it has, and it's not going to have a problem. The steel, though, the colder it gets, the more brittle it gets.
How does that connect it to the Titanic? Well, Titanic was made out of carbon steel, and the water was cold, and...
So when the ship collided with an iceberg, that brittle steel that it was made of, it fractured, and she went down.
Exactly. So, the cold resistance of Stala 350 makes it an ideal material for tough circumstances. And speaking of tough circumstances, while we are up here in the north, I want to take you to the origins of the high-strength stainless steel hollow sections.
Oh, boy.
Just a few more miles.
In the next episode, I have a special treat for Jamie. We are going to visit Outokumpu. That means strange hill in English. And take a look what makes high-strength stainless steel hollow sections the best. If you like to watch our tests, you can subscribe.